Hello there, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another day of play here at the StarLadder Star Series Season 14 for Europe. My name is Blue. I'm going to be your one and only caster for this evening in the single best of three between Team EnVyUS and E-Frag. Currently the knife round, because there's a little bit of a Mexican standoff right now between two of E-Frag's members and NBK right now. NBK challenging them in the chat. Wanting to force them on, but Dreamer and NKL don't want to take it. Look, even showing their backs. What is this? What's going on? They don't seem to want to fight. NBK wants it. Forcing them back right now. NBK trying to trick them, playing the mind games, saying he's AFK. Dreamer challenging it, testing it right now, thinking about pressing forward, but not going for it just yet. They're unsure. Look at them. Their emotions. They don't know what to think. Now they creep in slowly, very slowly, and all that for nothing. NBK falls, NKL finds the kill, and E-Frag win the knife round. So it's going to be starting off over here on cash, ladies and gentlemen. E-Frag has picked up the knife round, of course, so they're probably going to make the start on the CT side, and that is exactly what is going to happen now, as we should get started with the pistol round here at any moment. And then as for the guys over here on EnVyUS, they're going to have to jump onto the T side to start up this map. This is only our first out of three maps, however, as I, by the way, I'm going to adjust the volumes really quickly. Some things may be a little low and or high. The second map, once we do get to it, is going to be over on Inferno, and this is the pick from E-Frag, by the way, but the second map will be picked by Envy, and it's going to be played over on Inferno, and then our third and final map is going to be over on Train if we do need to play that one. The first team to two win it out, and of course, we are going live now with the first round, so let's get to it, ladies and gentlemen, and let's take a look. As we see here from Team EnVyUS, actually a very heavy early emphasis on pushing these players back over towards the B site. No commitment just as of yet, but hanging out just outside of the wrap area. And these guys are going to be pushing into it in just a moment, as now they press their way forward against it. Not a whole lot of defense placed here naturally by the members of E-Frag. In fact, they really only have Dreamer here to defend this. A couple more within close proximity, but Dreamer, he's going to connect a nice shot very early on in the beginning of this round by taking down Kenny S. Now Viktor looking to try and grab Happy at least as he transitions in the middle, but this is a very successful push so far. Unfortunately, once they did find that kill, it slowed down immensely from the side of E-Frag. So as we can see now, they're going to work their way back in, and they're actually having no trouble picking up these kills. Flawless re-execution coming out there from the members of E-Frag. Not a single player goes down in the process, and that retake happens so quickly, Auto Director can't even keep up with it. So there you have it, E-Frag, they're going to be able to pick up the first point here. Now they'll go up 1-0, and again, not a single player going down, so not looking so good for EnVyUS based off of the results here. Having no trouble at all getting into the site, but that's the trap that E-Frag set here. They play for that sort of retake strap by having a very minimal amount of players in the site initially, and due to that, obviously they're able to just roll right in there and overwhelm the members of EnVyUS by shutting them down. So there we have it now, and we see they immediately go for the three SMG investments here. Two M4s being picked up as well by both Dreamer and Viktor. So these guys are just going to look to try and stack up the cash a little bit, and spyleadeR is going to be the first one to do so as he drops NBK early on in the round. Pretty heavy cost to his own health pool, bringing him down to 8 HP, but still able to do a good job in executing that one. And now for Kenny, Kyo, along with Apex and Happy, they're going to have to try and work something else on their own, as they're going to be lonesome sitting mainly inside of A main, a couple more moving in from Squeaky as well, trying to make that push onto the A site. But E-Frag are going to be ready for this type of a push. spyleadeR is probably going to be a little bit vulnerable, but NKL is going to have a good angle for anybody that does push the forklift. He gets mollied, actually, so he's going to try to push out, but no, this doesn't work out so well. And NBK actually have a really good angle to push into this site. spyleadeR can't expose himself with only 8 HP. He's going to have to wait a couple extra seconds, looking for this flank, lining up one of these kills, but traded back by Kenny. That's going to take down spyleadeR. Now looking at Bubble, Dreamer, and Viktor trying to move in for this retake. Finally, that smoke fades out, but the post-plant positions have also come into play here now for the members of EnVyUS as well, and it's going to be a little bit harder to impact because of this one. Happy sitting inside of A-Man. They've got a couple more moving out there too. Kyo is going to need some help, but unfortunately, E-Frag are going to overwhelm him. They're trying to keep him back. That defuse is coming out from Bubble, and Kenny trying to tap it down. He's going to succeed in doing it, and now it's just Viktor. The question is, does he have enough time? And no, so much time has been wasted by E-Frag. EnVyUS are going to get the eco trade. Viktor thankfully survives, so he's going to keep his rifle in play, but still, EnVyUS strike right back, and now they've tied it up. This should destabilize things on E-Frag, and this is probably just going to be as much of a force as these guys could grab here on the second round. We do see that second rifle coming into play now from spyleadeR, so that's not too surprising. The rest of the guys go for their pistol armor buy-ups as well. Couple smokes, flashbang, and the HE coming into play there from NKL. And then for the rest of EnVyUS, of course, we've got the full rifles coming out from them because they do expect that double M4 to come into play now. But they're going to take it a lot slower this time because of that factor. So most of these guys just sitting back, not wanting to press themselves against any of the aggression here from E-Frag just as of yet. And in fact, Bubble has pushed himself inside of the vents. So that's going to be one player that they really are going to have to watch out for if they do go through with a sort of direct push over towards middle and trying to get vents control from there. But as these guys press forward, it's going to be Apex that picks up the first kill over onto Viktor. SpyLeadeR will be able to find a trade, but the big problem here is, again, is going to be EnVyUS getting good control of middle. But Bubble, again, as we were talking about before, blocks the way. That is a matter for Apex, though, as he just goes barreling inside and is able to drop Bubble. A little bit of a problem there when you consider his HP is brought down a little bit lower, but they're still able to handle it. And Dreamer tries to hold on to his own health pool here, but not going to succeed. NKL gets a little present there as Happy's back is turned against him. Not really expecting him to be inside of the A site, so he will end up dropping at least one more player and pick up a rifle as well. But I think he's just trying to get rid of some of these here, considering kioShiMa is still sitting on that Galil. If he can stop him from scavenging that M4, that's going to be the best course of action at this point. And definitely not going to be looking at the retake attempt from NKL. He's going to be sitting back and saving once more, as these guys are going to be on an eco in the next round. So, the best course of action, if they can keep this M4 in play, then obviously it's just going to increase their potency a little bit more. Still probably wouldn't put them over the edge to really be able to have this massive clutch going into the next round, but it can at least allow them to get a couple more frags into members of Team EnVyUS, which should allow them to keep the economy situation a lot more in their control before EnVyUS just get this huge stack of money on the T side. So we can already see it's... Again, they're going to have to go for a lot of rebuys here on the side of EnVyUS, so it's not necessarily going to grow just as of yet. But in time, if we do see like cleaner rounds coming out, like right here is going to be a perfect example of where we can have one, then EnVyUS's amounts are just going to grow substantially at this point forward. And obviously, E-Frag won't really be able to do anything about this on rounds like this, where they actually, surprisingly, as we can see, I'm completely caught off guard by this, as they go for the force up once again here now. They're actually not going to save just as of yet, because they still have that one rifle in play. So there's another round where they got two rifles, three upgraded pistol armor buys. So that's a bit interesting too, because this is still going to keep their money very low. Still not on that full losing bonus. They're just going to try for this once again, but Bubble waiting up inside the vents, trying to get the kill into Apex, and he's going to be able to find it. Shuts him out with a headshot, but as well, he rolls right back out, and Viktor's going to be able to grab another kill there too. Happy so far, picking up the only kill from EnVyUS as he's taken down Bubble, but the rest of the guys on E-Frag are holding out quite well, actually, so this buy seeming to work out for them so far, but now Kenny works his way in. He's going to be able to take out Dreamer. kioShiMa finding another frag as well over here onto SpyLeadeR, so it leads it into a 3-versus-2 situation, but both Kenny and kioShiMa have been hit pretty heavily down it. 40 HP and 25 HP, respectively, on both of those individuals. But Kenny, nice peek from him, able to drop Viktor. And again now, just going to be NKL, looking for those exit frags. And it will be a round that goes by the way of EnVyUS once again. So E-Frag with a good start to this one. A couple of good plays here by EnVyUS do bring things back and allow them to keep their lead strong here, but not necessarily their money just as of yet here. Whereas for E-Frag, they've basically emptied themselves out. They are technically still going to have this one gun in play, but to force it up three times in a row, that would be, in my eyes, a pretty unwise choice. But they've gotten fairly close to this now two times as well. How close, they don't know, but this time there's no way. They're going to have to go for a save, obviously. 2,700, 2,850 on Viktor is probably the biggest buy that they're going to have beyond what NKL already has. So these guys are not really going to be able to afford anything. They finally have to sit back, and this is now EnVyUS again. Now they have the walkover round. The good thing, though, is that E-Frag do have those two four-step rounds. They don't necessarily win them, but they get some good economical damage in, and now they only have to save one time compared to two if they had gone for a save previously. So in the long run of things, it does actually make a little bit more sense what E-Frag are doing. But to start this one off, we can see EnVyUS again putting a lot of their players through to the back B halls. A couple more lined up just outside of the boost spot over here, trying to get a little bit of control of middle, which they can transition into the vents as well. And Kenny S going to be investigating inside of A main to try and see if he can find anything here, but he hasn't actually been in here as of yet. So you can see he's taking a little bit more cautiously, just trying to make sure he doesn't actually run into anybody that's pushed in there and is holding an angle against these guys. Doesn't look like anyone from E-Frag has decided to do this, as they're actually playing fairly passively on this save round for the CT side. And KL, they have to make sure that he can impact as well as he needs to. But he's already been brought down to 22 HP, so it might be a good decision to trade out that gun with another teammate. Now they have the AK on SpyLeadeR too, so they are actually slowly getting armed up. Unfortunately for SpyLeadeR, the problem is that he does not have... Oh, good reaction shot there from NBK. And then Kenny, along with kioShiMa, just closed things out from there. Happy picks up a kill as well. And KL found one, but that might end up being the only kill they have. But SpyLeadeR's got a chance here. He's found his way inside of A main. Flash there only ends up blinding Happy. Doesn't hit. SpyLadeR at all. So he still has the world about him at this point as he now presses out. But he unfortunately has absolutely no clue where any of these members of EnVyUS are. He's going to know the Kyo is sitting behind Big Red now, but he has not spotted Happy. He's yet to fire his single shot from that truck position. So considering he doesn't find anybody forklift, this is too uneasy for him. And now that he's down at 23 HP, it's just not going to be worth it. He's got to fall back and, again, wants to save that rifle because this was a full eco round. So saving the rifle is going to keep them in play when they go for this fire, which I think should be coming up next here. They'll be on the fourth round losing bonus now, so yeah. Judging by what SpyLadeR has, they should definitely have enough cash to go for the buy here. That's indeed going to be the case here. So these guys finally getting their full buy in the sixth round. Two rounds late here, but they were forcing up a little bit there, so they were keeping things in contention at least a little bit here. But as for EnVyUS, they've been just pushing through a lot of these rounds here, and still not necessarily the cleanest. So E-Frag, again, if they're able to pick things up now that they finally have this full buy, they're immediately going to destabilize Envy, as they themselves have actually been having a little bit of trouble pushing their way through and closing out these rounds as cleanly as they would like. And that's been causing a couple of problems for them in terms of them just trying to build up money, despite the fact that they're now sitting on about four rounds in a row here. So, for EnVyUS, everybody moving into the back B halls again very early on into the round. He's trying to push their players into it. Bubble holding that same position inside of the vents. But he's going to have to try and take out Happy first, as he's going to try to push his way outside here in just a second and try and get some pressure going in middle. But Bubble actually popping out of the vents, dropping one, but only gives his life away there. But Dreamer as well was able to pick up a second kill over here on NBK. kioShiMa the one to take him out, but as we see more rolling into the site, there's going to be Kenny dropping Dreamer. But still, the T's are down a moment here. And for E-Frag, they're going to look for this retake pretty quickly, I imagine. Still trying to watch out because they haven't spotted where Happy is just as of yet. He's actually snuck his way inside of Checkers here, so he's going to wait for a rotation to come in through the vents. But this is probably not where it's going to come from. And right now, it's the Kenny show here as he picks up one kill on the SpyLadeR, takes some damage back from Viktor, and NKL pushing in through CT main here too. Trying to peek it again, gets that info on the player, but NKL takes down Happy, so now it's just Kenny, but he's going to be overwhelmed by NKL. That closes it out. A good play from him. And there we have it now, E-Frag. They're going to be able to pick up finally a second point for themselves. And like we were saying before, probably going to see one more force out coming out from EnVyUS, but if they drop that one, then E-Frag get back control of this game very, very quickly. And I do apologize, by the way, I don't know what's going on with my game sound at the moment, but it seems to be displaced for whatever reason. There's like random footsteps coming from other players that sound like they're happening on the player that's actually being spectated, so I don't know if that's a bug that's just me or whatever, but hopefully that'll fix itself on the second map. If not, I can try rejoining the server and maybe that shouldn't happen again, but we'll see. As again, now EnVyUS pressing themselves forward here to try and get themselves onto the A site. Viktor actually playing a very, very upfront angle, but he's going to have to be careful of Happy, who is inside of Squeak right now, looking for a very quick round out. However, E-Frag, look at the counter reaction they've done. They move themselves inside of A main now, and they're going to try to push these players back. It's worked, and look at SpyLadeR too, getting himself up into the face of NBK, takes him down. Thankfully, Kyo is swift enough on the trade, but now Viktor inside of A main shuts out another player. Great play from E-Frag, and now it's just kioShiMa sitting on the site. Does not even have control of the bomb, so he's stuck here. Nice little tap there to take out Dreamer, but he's got a long way to go to get himself back into this one. The final two players are separated to some degree, but the problem is that Bubble is waiting for him here over by the truck angle. And even if kioShiMa was able to successfully get himself inside, he still would have been trapped by Bubble, finding no way outside of A main. So there we go again, another round being picked up by E-Frag. Money's going to be a little bit too low here from EnVyUS now, so they're going to have to go for a save. Not necessarily a super weak save, as three deagles are in play, but no armor, no utility sitting behind any of this. So if you see those crazy deagle shots coming out here from the members of EnVyUS, it should still be a round that E-Frag should be able to easily run over. Speaking of those crazy shots, NBK finding one of the SpyLadeR right at the beginning of the round. Shuts him down with a Juan Deeg over there in a SpyLadeR sitting behind the white box. Just to the side of it. So he overpeaks that just a little bit now. And we can see another one coming out. kioShiMa going to be able to take down Dreamer. And NBK finally get another kill here. Takes out Viktor again. Back over by that white box angle. Bubble going to try to play it a little bit further up close here. But Kyo has that angle and he corrects his aim despite the aim punch finds the kill in a Bubble. And just like that, it's down to NKL, sitting back over here inside of Quad Corner. This is it. EnVyUS will pull it off. And now it's just going to be NKL trying to get some damage at the end of the round, because there's nothing he can do to try and stop this. The members of Team EnVyUS have placed themselves all over the map. There's nowhere for him to hide, and they're slowly going to be hunting him down here over the next few moments. Just trying to find him at this point, but NBK is looking for those longer range battles. As NBK finds his way through A main, nobody investigating back over here just as of yet. but they're slowly creeping in on him now. He can hear the footsteps, and he spotted one, but he's trying to hold it. Oh, they haven't actually seen him, so he's going to be able to light. No, only gets the one, and NBK is going to be able to respond to that one. Good reaction from him. No saves at all coming out from E-Frag, unfortunately, and look at all the free rifles that EnVyUS get for this now. The big problem for this round, of course, was trying to restabilize their economy, and not only do they do this with flying colors, but they also get basically 4 out of 5 of their rifles for this round for free. So that's a great pickup by EnVyUS, and it immediately gets them back into the lead here. And flips the tables onto E-Frag, who now have to go for their own save here. As you can see, they're going to have a little bit of a better one, as they'll have armor and whatnot sitting behind it, but no deagles in play, which were obviously a key component for EnVyUS to pick up that final round. So now we can see once again here for the members of Team EnVyUS. They're going to just push their way very, very slowly once again inside of A main, trying to find their way out onto the A site. And SpyLeadeR sitting in here is going to try to make that aggressive push. He spots this play so we can call the rotation, but nobody from EFRAG's moving against this. Nobody's working their way into the site, so EnVyUS are free to push in. Bubble tries to find that kill into Happy, but he's not going to be able to pick it up. And right now, members of EnVyUS, they're just waltzing onto that A site. Bubble finds his way out, at least gets this kill into Happy, finding a little bit of a rifle to work with here too. And Dreamer almost finding another frag back over here on a Kenny, but really bringing him down to 57 HP. The rest of EFRAG are now falling back. Dreamer's got armor and a PT-50, so that's a little bit of something to save. But Bubble's got the big one. He's got the CZ AK along with head armor, so he is definitely going to want to try and keep himself alive. Whereas, obviously, we'll be looking to Dreamer to try and hold that off a little bit further and prevent EnVyUS from finding him in the first place. But he's going to get challenged here by Apex, currently not looking towards that angle, so this could be rough. And there we go, that AK is now down on the ground, nothing left here for EFRAG. Dreamer gets his save more than likely, but it's a damn P250, so it's not the biggest save in the world, obviously. And for EnVyUS, great plays coming out from these guys. The big problem there for EFRAG is, obviously, again, just such a late call for the rotation, so these guys just don't react to that at all. They try to work their way, or they try to work their way back into that site, but it happens far too late. Even as well, there we saw, I think it was Dreamer or Viktor that get the early info there by going inside of A main, but there's literally zero reaction from the players on the B site and in the middle to try and move them into that. Bubble had a good position, he was trying to counter out Happy, and he actually does end up picking up the kill, but for the rest of the guys that are sitting on B site, there's really no reason for them to be sticking around that late, so it's just, unfortunately, a bit of a bad situation there that lost EFRAG the round, but now they're going to try to swing it back here. Happy finding a first kill, but Viktor, they have that crossfire angle, so thankfully they are able to find the correction kill and take him down. Bubble 2 is going to get pressured pretty heavily in a second, but he's able to hold on, picking up a first kill. NBK is there for the trade once again, but this is not what EFRAG want to have to deal with here, considering the fact that, again, they're basically on a full save here from the side of EFRAG, but now Kenny, he's got the op into his hands, picking up that kill over here onto NKL. Stuck inside of checkers for now. And in fact, Apex is going to be able to pick up an additional kill here too, so it's just SpyLeadeR. But SpyLeadeR, not realizing that the last CT here is sitting himself on the bomb position, so the Molly comes back out. SpyLeadeR looking to execute that final kill, but that Molly's going to force him out of position for the time being. He's just going to press up against Kenny right now. That pop flash comes out, should completely blind SpyLeadeR, but it's not that great. However, Kenny S finds a flick shot and is going to be able to take him down there. Takes him down, and now it's EnVyUS leading 7-3 against the members of Team EFRAG. And obviously, too, with EFRAG getting through these ecos once again, we'll be able to see them putting the M4s into their own hands. A little bit lower on utility than I think they would like to work with, but they still have the full rifles, full armor, and everything. So it still should be enough to hold the things off here, and we're going to see that Molly use very early. One of the smokes and the T's have to come out, but Kenny, spotting one of the positions of these players, is going to be able to come out and find a frag. Thankfully, a little bit of over-aggression from EFRAG allows Dreamer and SpyLeadeR combining themselves to pick up a kill back over there in the back B halls, but the play's not coming from this direction. They're going to have to move in. Kenny finding a trade again as NKL picks up a kill back over there. And again, we see NBK saving Kenny's life as he takes down Bubble. Kenny survives that encounter with just 13 HP, so he's going to have to hold back a little more. Things are in very good control from the side of EnVyUS, though. SpyLeadeR and Dreamer now moving in for the retake, but they've got very few angles to work with, and they're basically going in blind at this point. So NBK already going to find the one shot there to take out SpyLeadeR. Dreamer finding two. He still has no clue where Kenny is. Obviously, there's a very few key spots where he could be hiding. This might not be one of them, however. So Dreamer, again, not even going to attempt this. He just decides to fall back and moves away from this play and is going to look for the save as he's, again, got a decent amount. So no real harm moving away to try to keep that rifle alive. But EnVyUS are now starting to get into a dangerous position with the amount of lead that they have here. Up to those 8 points is sort of what we expect here, so we sort of want EFRAG to win on every single round from this point forward, the final four that would be. But if EnVyUS are able to proceed forward and potentially get themselves up to like a 10-5 or 11-4, then this is when EnVyUS obviously hold a very, very large lead against the members of EFRAG, which This is a very even map. You expect about an 8-7, 9-6 of the worst side advantage, really towards either T or CT. Normally more CT sided, but things like that should not be happening that heavily in a lead from EnVyUS. And especially the big problem too is now Kenny has actually been not even really been using the AWP for all of that much of this half. He's just now started to pick it up here in these past couple of rounds. And obviously that T-sided AWP is a lot harder to make as much impact on, so jumping out on the CT side and assuming they get a good start to their economy where he's able to pick that up, if he's allowed to use it without too much restriction, then that could be another big factor working against E-Frag now once we see EnVyUS jumping out on the CT side. But in this round at least, E-Frag starting it off pretty good. Streamer and Viktor picking up the first two kills here, and MKL has plastered his aim right now over here on AMA, and despite Squeaky Door opening up, he is relying on his teammate Kenny, gonna try to peek out, but not expecting a player to be sitting up on top. NBK, though, did make progress. He took down Spyler, so this is actually gonna force NKL back, and then NBK, we saw Kenny getting the intel there that he ended up falling back down, so he's gonna be able to just take him down through the door, eliminates him. That's a great shot coming out from NBK to eliminate him, and now we see more of these guys moving into the site, but they're injured pretty heavily at this point. That doesn't matter, though, for NBK. Rolls in, finds Viktor, picks up the headshot onto him, now they're gonna get the plant situation going. And E-Frag have lost all the advantages they had starting off earlier on in this round. Bubble moving in, he's gonna look to take out Kenny back by forklift, but has no clue he's there. And Kenny picks up the final two kills. Both Bubble and Dreamer go down, does that with 23 HP. They have absolutely no clue what hits them. And EnVyUS retake control once again, now up to 9-3. And for E-Frag, they'll be broken once again. They've got an okay amount if they wanted to force it, and that's actually gonna be the choice they make. I thought they were gonna eco, but they will choose to go for the force up instead. And this is not about force at all. Obviously, three FAMASs and M4s, so you got four rifles in play. Spyleader is the only player that has to go for a little bit of a pistol buy, but there's good reason to it, as obviously he needs to get the kit for at least one of the guys on this team, and he buys up the utility for these players as well. But kioShiMa trying to get that spray down early on in the round, does connect a little bit of damage on the Dreamer, but it's much more heavily traded back against him, as both NBK and kioShiMa take about 40% of their health pool down. Dreamer again, realizes that the pressure may be coming in, holding off, picks up two as NBK and Apex are dropped. Unfortunately, things go much better for EnVyUS as they trade out the kills a lot better. Viktor looking for this flank against kioShiMa to try and take him down, but gives it up a little bit too early as he falls away from this one. And this might be again another early save call coming out for the members of E-Frag. They're falling back over here inside of the squeaky area, and they're not actually going to attempt anything else. As the members of Team EnVyUS here should have full control of the B site, and for E-Frag, there's too much doubt as to what exactly will be going on there, so they're going to have to pull away from this one. And E-Frag will just have to look to save these rifles once again, as they've invested everything and they want to try to prevent, because they are going to be on an eco once again in the next round, considering they've just force bought. They want to try to prevent just having absolutely nothing in play, but EnVyUS, again, not really a whole lot of challenge for them once they got their feet onto the ground. E-Frag had an okay start to this one, picking up a couple rounds towards the beginning, but once we saw EnVyUS getting past those couple of hiccups there, they were immediately able to retake control. And now again, the economy becomes a big problem for these guys too, because we're going to head into one of the final couple of rounds here and EnVyUS easily with enough money to buy through pretty much everything, even if we do see E-Frag starting to win some impact rounds here, as again, it looks like they might be forcing this up for a second time. They're on the full losing bonus, so I suppose they could do this time and time again, but missing crucial things like bringing the AWP into play and whatnot, bigger utility buys with M4s, I should mention, because again, we are still seeing a little bit more utility coming into play, but it's back down to FAMASs now, so that's the other big problem in play too, is they're not going to have as much impact as the M4s, but they will get actually pretty aggressive this time, at least in middle, as Viktor pushes way up to the doors. Happy going to be popping over in a second. Nobody watching that angle for the time being, but Viktor checking it out now. Happy going to try to react to it. He does finish off that player, but down to 32 HP now, so not the best trade that he could look for here. And the rest of the guys on EnVyUS are positioned mainly over here into the back B halls. They're going to look for basically a direct push into B. Happy, I think, wanted to try and find a way in events, but is not going to get it. Now Dreamer popping out. Does get some damage onto the members of Team EnVyUS, but not going to be able to find a kill. And they're going to try to take him down through the wall, waiting for the peak. They find that frag. Spyler going to drop down in a second. He's down on the floor, so he picks up one kill, almost finding a second, but not going to be able to grab things just as of yet. Meanwhile, E-Frag going for that rotation. NKL actually still expecting, for whatever reason, something to come into A. And there is somewhat of a good reason for this one now, as Bubble has not actually found any aggression themselves, but Happy's going to be able to pick up that kill into the B site. So they were going for A second ago. They might pull this away now and just go for B. However, NKL is the final player left alive, so 4 versus 1. Really not a whole lot of risk either way. If they really wanted to play it super safe, like if they were in E-Frag's position right now, you would sort of expect them to go back towards B, but this is not going to be happening. NBK's hunting him down. Now they know where he is, so they can just position themselves to counter out any push from the CT direction here. Happy's gonna peek it out. It's actually a pretty ballsy peek from Happy, and that unfortunately feeds them another kill. Zenkale's gonna be free to pick this one up, looking for an additional one, but thankfully, Apex is going to be able to close things out without any further conflict there. And EnVyUS now we're gonna be able to pick up their 11th point here. And E-Frag get their buy going once again. This time they're going to upgrade to the M4s, but the utility is going to be a big problem. He has to get four smokes to work with, so they're going to have good coverage early on in the round. But for people like Spyler, who don't have anything, and even when you look at the greater scheme of things, they don't have any mollies and whatnot. So holding off big five-man pushes, or holding off the bigger three or four-man pushes, which is definitely been more what EnVyUS have been looking towards here. Holding off situations like that are going to be a lot harder to do. As, again, they've been struggling to this for most of this half coming out from EnVyUS so far. But thankfully, E-Frag's spy leader is going to be able to pick up the first kill here now. Taking down Happy. As again, EnVyUS a little bit over aggressive, so it does give E-Frag the opportunities that they need to pick up at least a couple kills early on in the round. Bubbly is going to end up taking some heat, literally, as he gets some molly damage back over there inside of the vents. He does have to retreat inside of it. Now, because he's a little bit nervous of a push that would come outside of middle, and it might be a boost here in a second too, as Apex is looking for it. He's going to get jumped up on top. There's a lot of players waiting for him in middle list. This is going to get risky. Trying to line up against Viktor, but very rough angle being placed up against him now. There's going to be NBK peeking outside of the garage door main, though, so that does take him down, but now Viktor is going to be able to finish off Apex. The rest of these players looking to find their way inside of B now, and they're going to do this. kioShiMa finds out Dreamer, takes him down. Bubble holding strong. He does hold off NBK, but that peek from Kenny shuts down Bubble, and now it's just NKL once again. He's going to have to make the attempt this time. It's the final round, but with how slow he's rotating in, it's going to give EnVyUS all the time they need to get themselves into post plant. So, Kenny watching CT main, they already know he's going to be coming from this direction. He was watching from heaven there too, so as soon as he gets a whiff that he's up there, and he spotted him, not even going to need the support of Kenny, kioShiMa just swipes that headshot away, takes down NKL, and that is going to be the half, guys, in the favor of Team EnVyUS, very dominantly, 12-3, coming out for the guys on Team EnVyUS. Just four more away from winning map number one, and E-Frag, unfortunately, with a whole lot of work to do on this CT side, and it's going to have to start off right in the first round with a victory on the pistol. We have seen comebacks like this before, but again, EnVyUS have looked very, very dominant so far. Not so much in the rounds that it would be impossible for E-Frag to make a comeback. Keep in mind that these rounds have been a little bit closer than necessarily the round score, the round share shows. However, with the round share that we currently have spread out, there is basically no room for E-Frag to make any mistakes in the second half, because they give EnVyUS even an inch, they're going to take a mile here at this point with the big lead that they have going for themselves. So they have to be very, very careful about this. So it's actually a bit of a standoff here at the beginning of the first, or the second pistol round now. As we can see, basically nobody moving early on in this round. Everybody looking out for aggression from one side or the other here. As E-Frag now going to press themselves forward. Just going to go for the mid play, it looks like, as they press themselves up top boost. And it's going to be Viktor, along with one other player, moving themselves towards this one. EnVyUS, to some degree, are going to be expecting a play to come from middles. They have placed an extra player here, and there's Kenny now picking up the first one. Viktor firing the shot, so they know his position, and now SpyLeader another one. It's going to be NKL. They move their way in back over here towards the vents. Molly explodes, but again, Kyo holding that safe corner. NBK taking a very risky position inside of the small pit. He's actually going to be able to pick up a kill, though, before being traded out by Bubble, and now Kyo comes into play. He's going to deck down Bubble. It's just SpyLeader now, and he's overwhelmed by Happy. He rolls inside of the vents there. Great execution from EnVyUS, and that's going to be crushing now for the members of E-Frag, as if they don't respond here on this second round by going for a Tech 9 4 sub, which they just might have to do, to be honest, then that could be EnVyUS immediately getting up to the 15 point marker. But I think they're actually going to purposefully save here to try to go for the third round 4 sub. Despite the fact that they get no plan here in the first round, you can still technically do that third round 4 sub, but it's going to be very, very limiting. And if they can get some okay damage here, then it might be worth it in itself. But considering the fact that, again, they've invested basically nothing into this round, that can make things that much harder as well, as they've got 5 Glocks, nothing else. They just AFK'd the buy phase and walked out of spawn. So, nothing being invested from these guys on purpose this time. And for EnVyUS, obviously, they expect a little bit more to come out from these players, as they haven't gone for 3 rifle investments and a P90 sitting on Kenny. So, they're not going to take this one lightly. And as we can see, already these guys moving in. It's a shutdown from EnVyUS. So far, not a single kill picked up. There's SpyLeader. In the meantime, finding one, almost grabbing a second. But Happy's going to be able to take him down with that nade. And now EnVyUS sitting at their 14th point here. 2 more away. But as for the members of E-Frag, they're going to go for that force up here in the third round, as we expected. Very, very limiting, though, when you take a look at it. Obviously, we'll see a couple very, very small investments. Actually, no smokes being brought. There's one now that comes out from NKL, but with the exception of him, no smokes at all being brought in from this team at all. They buy HEs over the smokes, in fact. Both SpyLeader and Dreamer choose to do this, and SpyLeader is able to get himself 2 flashbangs. But 3 Galils, 2 AKs. We'll see what they can work with. Everybody's got armor to work with, too, but everybody's blind. Look at this Dreamer and Apex literally sitting right next to each other, but neither can see the other one. The smoke comes out from the CTs. They spot that this play is going to come in earlier on, and they have to hold themselves back a little bit. This is unfortunate, but now they're actually going to get aggressive. However, what the heck? Dreamer doesn't react to this one at all. Tries to hold the trigger discipline, but that doesn't pay off for him, as he's taken down by Apex. SpyleadeR thankfully finding the trade on the NBK. But now he's been forced outside of AME, and the initial plan from E-Frag has gone down the drain. There is going to be way of an over-aggressive push coming out from Apex, though. Just trying to get info there, so that feeds Viktor to kill. He takes down Apex. And now E-Frag again. They get back a little bit more of an advantage here, as they're going to be up a player. They work their way in. Happy has no clue that NKL is moving his way in. Thankfully, kioShiMa's in a good position to find a trade. Now this is down to a 3v2. E-Frag again trying to get themselves boosted up to try and take some mid control, but that may not even be necessary at this point, as these guys, again, they basically only have to deal with one player on either site, depending on where they decide to go for. So they're going to move in. kioShiMa does expect this to move itself towards the A site, as he's already positioned there, and it's the same story for Kenny. He's actually in middle, not really checking B too heavily, but they are trying to investigate a little bit. Bubbles position himself inside of here. Viktor finding another kill, taking down Kyo, and now it's just Kenny with a P90 looking to try and close this one out. And they still haven't gotten that plant going. They're finally going to get some security, and obviously we see Bubble falling outside of the site, but they'll move themselves away from this one. And for Kenny now, he's gonna have to make the choice. Ignore those footsteps sounds once again. That is a sound bug, because it's not actually Kenny being that loud right now. That's someone else walking around the map. It's just triggering that for some reason on my screen, so I'm gonna have to try and fix that. But this is gonna be a save attempt now coming out from Kenny, as E-Frag, their third round Hail Mary force up, has succeeded. And for the guys left alive here, EnVyUS is Kenny S trying to find that kill over on the Bubble, but Bubble's gonna win the long range still there. Almost takes him down with the nade, but not gonna happen. And indeed, we see E-Frag closing out at least one round here, still on extremely thin ice, considering the situation that they have placed themselves into. But this does give them a little bit more of a chance now, comparatively to if they drop that round, they would be broken, because they would have just forced up, and EnVyUS would have basically had the map. So they have a chance now. And we are paused. I'm not exactly sure why. I believe there has been a connection issue, possibly with NKL. But everybody looks fine on my screen. Could be choke, though. So, imagining NKL's having some problems. But as soon as these guys fix it, which hopefully shouldn't be too long judging from their current pings, we should be able to unpause things and get themselves right back into this matchup. And they have called out the signal to go now, so just waiting on EnVyUS, I think, to unpause it, and then we'll get live with the match once again. But this will be the full save, more than likely, coming out from EnVyUS. If they save on time, they're immediately good to go for a rebuy once again. And this includes, assuming weapon trades are brought back out, this does include an op that goes over here on a Kenny S, so I imagine this will be a fairly light round. Actually, no, they go for a little bit heavier of an investment, not a huge one. Should still be able to potentially go for a buy in the next round, but they are going to try to take the risk on it this time by going for the pistol armor investments and a couple of utility buys here too. We see three deagles again in play, and they pulled off this type of round before, actually with less impact, considering they didn't have armor when they pulled off this eco upset previously. But the big risk being taken here is only leaving Happy on that B site, which is not going to pay off at all. The rotations for EnVyUS are going to be very slow as well, so these guys work their way in. Happy trying to line up the frags, picking up one. There's the bomb carrier, almost grabbing a second, but now he's stuck in the corner. Tries to throw out that smoke, hiding in the corner, but not going to happen. More trying to rotate back in. They're getting some good damage onto these members of E-Frag, but E-Frag, the push comes out too strong, and EnVyUS, they've chosen the wrong site to throw all their eggs into here. So deep nade comes out there from Dreamer, too. That's going to shut down NBK, and now it's just Kyo and Kenny trying to pull off a miracle 2v4 at this point. Like we said before, they have brought down quite a few of these guys to lower amounts, and Kyo trying to line up one of them, but no, overexposes himself. And that's going to be Dreamer finding the headshot frag there. Takes down kioShiMa. Kenny's now the last one alive. Sitting inside that smoke, he's got a super small angle to look through, where I don't actually believe he can be spotted. But now he's going to have to fall back a little bit more. And again, he's allowed E-Frag members to escape. So no exit frags are going to be maintained. He actually, I was going to say, he might try to go back in and pick up at least one of the rifles there that are sitting on the floor, or one of the deagles, but they move everybody out. And Dreamer, too, with the 4K that round, I should mention as well. Despite the fact that that was, for the most part, an eco round, there was a lot of chaos going on. So it's actually pretty impressive for Dreamer to pick up all four of those kills that happened, and really saves his team a whole lot of stress because of that one. So, again, here we see the investment coming out from Team EnVyUS. No op coming into play for Kenny just as of yet. The money, unfortunately, is not in that safe of a situation. But the important thing, again, is that they're able to do this. Not as much of an impact on that last run as I think they were looking for. Looking to either win out that last run, absolutely, or looking to, at the very least, get 3 to 4 kills to try and keep the money low on the T side. That doesn't happen. We still see the members of E-Frag with a pretty good buy coming out here. And a decent amount left over, too, for a couple of these guys. So, if EnVyUS are going to be able to win out this first gun round here, then we should immediately be able to see the guys on E-Frag go for another buy themselves. How strong it'll be is still yet up to question, but we'll have to wait on this one. And again, EnVyUS having a little bit more trouble with their CT side, but we're still very, very early on in the second half here. Peaks and come out. Happy picking not up only one kill, but two kills too as they try to go for the boost. Happy's counter-boosted and just absolutely shuts these players out of the picture. Now more moving in. Dreamer thankfully having a little bit more luck with this one as he's going to be able to move in and take down Apex, but Happy's repositioned himself. He's now inside of the garage. They can't make any regular push outside of this for the time being, especially because Dreamer's fallen back now, so it's not that they could try to get the flank for the flanker. And Happy finding another kill here. NBK also picking one up from the quad corner. He is going to be able to get traded out there by SpyleadeR. But this round so far, very much so in the control of the members of Team EnVyUS here. It's going to be Spyler that tries to do something, but he leaves himself out in the open. And that's just an easy execution now that comes out from Happy, shutting him out. And 15-5 is going to be the scoreline here. EnVyUS just one more round away from closing it out. And E-Frag, unfortunately, they're going to have to go for a buy. But three AKs in play. Two of these guys are going to have to go for Tech 9 buys. It's going to be NKL along with Viktor. Actually, correct myself. NKL just goes for the all-in. He just buys the AK and the armor. No head armor, which is going to be a little bit rough here going against the CTs. But also not having any utility for it as well. So that could become a bigger problem. But from Team EnVyUS, I'm saying but a lot. Apologies. When we look at the members of Team EnVyUS, though, again, they're not actually secure as of yet either. They're actually in pretty much a weaker position than E-Frag are. They've got NBK working against there with a PP Bison. Apex has to downgrade himself over here to a 5-7. And then you've got the three M4s coming into play here. With a couple HEs. Mainly just flashbangs and smokes, though, for the utility side of this one from the members of Team EnVyUS. Again, going to look to hold things off with this one. Which, E-Frag do have a little bit of an advantage in this engagement. But a killer lineup here in mid could become troublesome. Kyo is sitting inside. He knows that this push is going to come back out against these players. One sitting behind the white box, too. He's even supported by this smoke here. Bubble's going to be able to take down Kyo. But Apex, there's one from him. And he gets the second one, too. Looking for a third. Brings SpyleadeR down to 22 HP. Four players still left alive here from Team EnVyUS. And SpyleadeR trying to look for a way through. But now it's just SpyleadeR as the final player left alive. Happy and NBK have picked up two frags on that A site. The bomb now in the control of the CTs. But SpyleadeR looking for a way back in to claim it. It's not going to happen. Apex shuts out the final kill. And that's going to be map number one, ladies and gentlemen. 5-16 is going to be the round score. And we do see EnVyUS taking it very convincingly there. A little bit of trouble there as E-Frag got a little bit more success here on the second half. But ultimately, it's the members from EnVyUS that ended up shutting it down. So our second map here in Inferno is going to be coming up in just a few moments, guys. Stick around and we'll be right back with more of the StarLadder Star Series Season 14 right here on Twitch.